Hello friends, welcome to my channel Dev's Institute. Today we are going to learn new topic about 8255 programmable peripheral interface, that is operating modes of 8255 PPI. Before you watch this video, you must know the architecture of 8255, which is I have already shared on a YouTube channel. So first go through the video of YouTube 8255 architecture and pin diagram, then only you will be able to understand operating modes of 8255. Before I start, I request you to subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscribe button given below the video and click on bell icon for instant notification. It's absolutely free of cost. Operating modes of 8255. 8255 can operate in two modes. First mode is bit set reset mode, that is called as BSR mode, and another one is input output mode, that is IO mode. IO mode is again divided into three subcategories. Mode 0 is simple IO, mode 1 is strobed IO, and mode 2 is strobed bidirectional IO. First we will see what is BSR mode and then we'll move towards IO mode. BSR mode is a bit set reset mode. As we all know that 8255 contains three ports, port A, port B, port C. Port C is divided into two parts, port C upper and port C lower. Bit set reset mode is applicable only to port C. Here you can set or reset any bit from PC0 to PC7 by using control word register. So this is format for control word register and we are talking about BSR mode. Control word register is 8 bit long. The D7 bit of control word register is D7 bit is used to represent the mode of the 8255. So here D7 bit is 0, 0 is used to represent the BSR mode. So D7 bit is 0 to represent BSR mode. If your 8255 is working in BSR mode, the next three bits of control word register are don't care, they are not used. Then you have three bits to select a specific bit from port C. So if these bits are 000, PC0 will be selected, 001, PC1 pin will be selected, 010, PC2 pin will be selected, likewise up to PC7. And this last bit, D0 bit, you can give here the value to be assigned to this particular port C pin. So this can be either 0 or 1 depending upon whether you have to set the pin or reset the pin. So here by using these three bits you can select the specific pin number, specific pin from port C, and by using this you can either set it or reset it. So this is for BSR mode. Next is IO mode. Again, this is control word register, same control word register is used. So here D7 bit is 1. In last case D7 bit is 0. D7 bit is 0, it means it is BSR mode. D7 bit is 1, it means it is IO mode. In IO mode, then for D6 and D5 bits are group A mode selection bits. So we know that we have studied in architecture of 8255 that 8255 contains three ports, port A, port B, port C. Port C is divided into port C upper and port C lower. Group A consists of port A and port C upper, and group B consists of port B and port C lower. So this is group A mode. Group A mode, there are two bits assigned for group A mode. So there are three different modes: 00 mode 0, 01 mode 1, and 1 don't care is mode 2. We'll see details about this mode in next slides. This bit is for port A. So if this bit is 1, it means port A will work as input mode. If this bit is 0, it means port A will work as output mode. Then next bit is PC upper. So PC upper port, 1 for input and 0 for, again 0 for output. Then group B mode. In group B mode, 0 is for mode 0 and 1 is for mode 1. Only two modes you can assign to group B. Group B consists of port B and port C lower. Group B mode, 0 for mode 0, 1 for mode 1. Port B, again, if this is 1, port B will work as input mode. If this is 0, port B will work in output mode. PC lower, so if this is 1, PC lower port will work as input mode. If this is 0, it will work as output mode. Now we will see input output modes in detail. So there are three modes: mode 0, mode 1, mode 2. Mode 0 is a simple IO mode, and mode 0 is applicable to both the groups, group A and group B. So here port A and B will work as 8 bit port. Port C will work as 2 4 bit ports. Port can be configured as either input mode or output mode, simple IO mode. Outputs are latched, inputs are not latched. Ports do not have interrupt capability. So this is simple IO mode. Port A and B can be used as a 8-bit input mode or output mode. Port C can be used as a 2 4-bit ports, either in input mode or output mode. So this is about simple IO. Then next mode is mode 1, that is strobed IO. In strobed IO mode, port A and B can be used as 8-bit port, but port C has assigned some different functionality here. So port C, 3 lines from port C are used by port A for handshaking, to share the or to transfer the handshake signals, and 3 lines from port C will be used by port B as a handshake signal. So if you know the concept of computer network, then you may be knowing the handshake signals. Handshake signals are nothing but the extra signals sent along with or before the start of communication or after the data has completely sent, to indicate start of communication and end of communication or acknowledgement type of. So these are the extra signals that are not part of the data. So in strobed IO, port A and B will be used as 8-bit ports. Port A will use 3 lines from port C as a handshake signal, and port B will use 3 lines from port C as a handshake signal. Output, inputs and outputs are latched. Then mode 2 is a strobed bidirectional IO. Now see, only group A can be group A can work in mode 2, because for group B you have only single bit. Here group B has only single bit, so it can work in either mode 0 and mode 1, port B and port C lower. Group A can work in mode 3, that is strobed IO. So strobed bidirectional IO, port A can be configured as bidirectional port and not port B, because port B belongs to group B. Port B, in that case, port B can be either in mode 0 or mode 1. Port A uses 5 signals from port C as a handshake signals, and remaining 3 signals from port C can be used either as simple IO or handshake for port B. I repeat last 2 points. See, port A can be configured as bidirectional port because it belongs to group A. Port B belongs to group B. There is no mode 2 for group B. So port B, in that case, port B can be either in mode 0 or mode 1. Now, port A is a bidirectional port. So port A uses 5 signals from port C as a handshake signal for data transfer. So in last mode, mode 1, 3 signals were used as a handshake signal. Here 5 signals will be used as a handshake signal for data transfer. Now we remain with the 3 signals from port C. Port C contains 8 signals. 5 signals are used by port A for for handshaking and it is bidirectional port. Remaining three signals from port C can be used as either simple IO or handshake for port B. So if your port B is working in mode 0, then port C will be used as a simple IO, and if it is mode 1, then 3 lines will be required by port B for handshaking purpose. So this is all about the operating modes of 8255. I hope you have understood concept of 8255 operating modes. If you like video, please press like button given below the video. If you have any queries, you can ask me through comment section. Thank you.